Should we be bullish given those risks or more tempered with markets near record highs?
I think we should be bullish with the caveat of a defensive feeling behind our bullishness. So, you know, a lot of good news came out of the weekend. So G20 went better than expected, or it seems like the markets thought that G20 went better than expected. So we have some signs of a trade truce or at least ongoing talks about trade. The two main issues have been essentially slowing global growth and and reduced PMIs and reduced earnings and things like that. And I think that trade was the bigger geopolitical overhang. And now we have, you know, sort of uncertainty with the growing global growth, but we have a little bit more of a what feels like a Trump put and a Fed put, which can help the market. So it's a mixture of both.
What seems so odd to me, at least, is this idea that technology, a very economically sensitive sector, has been far and away the best performing sector in the S&P 500 so far this year. That says to me, hey, growth should be picking up, yet you mention all of these signs of a possible slowdown globally. Where is the disconnect there?
Right. So the disconnect, if you look at tech and semiconductors and some of these names, they have rallied, but they have also been the biggest names to pull back in December and also again in May when some of these geopolitical tensions and other factors like slowing PMI come into the market. So it almost seems like when we have no news in the market, it's good news. And the FANG names rally and the growth semiconductor names rally. Like, look at what happened this weekend, right? The Huawei suppliers rallied, the robotics names, the chip makers all did quite well because it looks like, at least in the short term, we have some positive momentum for those names to continue growing. But what could happen is that we may see some of our gains reverse if that trade deal doesn't actually come to fruition. You know, if we don't get the Fed cuts perhaps that the market expected. And we also have to wait and see what happens with earnings because, you know, China tariffs weren't in play for that long. But it's possible that there is now an impact to the bottom line and there is an impact to the consumer who has to pay more for these goods. So we sort of have to see what happens in terms of the long-term trajectory.
So the company that you work for manages a number of different types of sector ETF products that show either bullishness or bearishness in parts. From your mind, in seeing the fund flows, is there any kind of indication right now that there is more of an aggressive risk-taking profile for investors and traders, or is it becoming more tilted towards those consumer staples and utilities and real estate and that sort of thing?
So I would say that for the first time, we sort of see flows across the board in both, and here's why. I think in the short term, traders love it. You know, yesterday we saw 200 to 300% increase 20-day ADV in semiconductors and technology, anything China-related. Our China Internet ETF, our China A-shares, our China H-shares ETF, robotics. So everything FANG, tech, China, Huawei, everything that had to do with the trade war rallied yesterday. In the last 2 days, we saw double-digit returns and we saw, you know, 100, 200, 300% change in volume and growth. But, you know, over time, we have seen investors at least or heard investors talking with us about, you know, it will be a lot of volatility in the market. I want these short-term gains and these short-term opportunities, but longer term, I do want to look at names like healthcare, you know, late cycle performers, perhaps names that got, you know, that did a little bit better in December when the rest of the market got banged up and have sort of strong balance sheets, strong dividends and things like that. So short term, you know, fangy growthy opportunities right now, long term, reposition a little bit with some defensive names.